How's it going, guys? People always mock me for typing long messages on WhatsApp and text and ask me how I can type a lot so fast. I've since shortened my long messages to those people who complain. I still thought it was useful to share how I could type long text messages so fast, so I uploaded a video in 2015 on how to send text messages, the type of message sent through your cellular provider on your computer using MightyText for Android, and also how to send WhatsApp and Viber text messages, both Android and iOS. Today, Android Messages notified me that I can now send text messages through my computer. The notification shows up at the bottom of your phone, somewhere here. I forgot to screenshot it when I first saw it because I was so excited, but you get the option to try it now or later. As you know, I'm not a tech reviewer of the latest and the greatest. Everything that's mildly tech-related in this YouTube account is about things that I've used in my personal life and my thoughts about those. Sending text messages, whether SMS or various online messengers, over the computer is a major convenience for me, as sometimes my phone is in another room charging and I can't be bothered to get up and I'm on a computer. I often copy and paste long bits of information to people I text, which is very convenient to do when I'm already in the computer. I just use my mouse and keyboard instead of getting up, looking for the info again on my phone, and then sending it. I've been using MightyText to send text messages through my computer for a few years now. When I made that 2015 video, I was actually only using the free version then. I've since upgraded to the premium version that has a few more features like themes. The dark theme is great for my eyes. The ability to view all phone notifications from the computer, not just SMS. No sending limits, and can back up your messages for more days. They also have other pro features that I don't use but others may find useful, like signatures that get automatically appended after your text message, scheduling texts, bulk texts, and number block. When I first signed up for Pro, it was $39.99 annually. But now their site says it's $79.99 per year. That's a bit too expensive for me. I don't know if my rate will go up when I renew or not. If it does, I'll be forced to cancel my Pro subscription. I already wrote to ask. If you want to know more about how to link MightyText to your phone and the usage experience, please watch my 2015 video. I'll link to it below. Not much has changed drastically in the 3 years since I made it. Back to Android Messages in the web. You access it the same way you link WhatsApp Web and Telegram Web to your phone, by clicking on Messages for Web in your Google Messages app on the phone, then scanning a QR code in messages.android.com in your computer browser. Try it. Note, this is dependent on your phone being online. If your phone is not, then messages.android.com can't load your SMS inbox. It's not like Viber for a PC that functions independently of the phone app. By the way, my Android Messages web interface is in Portuguese because I set one of my numerous devices to Portuguese before, since I'm studying it. So some of the web versions assume that I want the language displayed in that language. For now, I don't see the option to change the language in messages.android.com on PC. Anyway, it's all sort of self-explanatory. Here, you'll see some of the options available. Just try out the rest on your own. The most important first step, though, is to change it to a dark theme, so you don't go blind. I'd just like to highlight some differences that matter to me between this and MightyText Pro. One thing I like about MightyText is that you can lay out all your messages in a grid. They're not just in this long line with the various conversations in the left sidebar and the chat thread on the right. But you also have the option to pop out a specific text conversation in MightyText into a new window. It's very handy if you want to keep it pinned on screen while you're doing something else. For now, Android Messages does not have this, or if it does, I don't know how to activate it. I tried double-clicking and right-clicking. Scheduled messages is a big feature that MightyText Pro has that Android Messages on the web doesn't have yet. I also don't see all my text message threads in Android Messages on the web. In MightyText Pro, I don't really know how many messages it keeps, but I keep clicking load more on the bottom and more just show up. I don't recall how many the non-paid MightyText keeps. When you click on a message on Android Messages on the web, it also marks the text as read on your phone. But in MightyText, it just dismisses the notification, but the text is still marked unread. This is an important distinction because for people who get tense at unread texts, it can be a surprise to look at your phone hours later and see 25 unread texts, when it turns out you've already responded to them all. It just didn't reflect on the actual text messaging app on your phone. It's kind of like back in the Pebble smartwatch days, when you read a message on your watch, it dismisses the notification, but the actual unread text message count in the phone app does not change until you physically click on your phone. I can also access MightyText on my tablet. For now, Android messages in the web just works in your computer web browser. There's no Android tablet-specific app yet. This feature is handy because sometimes I'm in another place and my phone is charging, and I can use my tablet to reply to messages. I'm even notified of phone calls, then I run fast to my phone to answer it. Both MightyText Pro, but not free, and Android messages in the web have an option for dark themes. The color scheme of Android messages in the web is just like what it looks like on the phone. So every conversation is a different color. On MightyText, every conversation has the same color. If your contact has a Google profile picture, it also shows up on Android messages in the web. MightyText Pro also allows you to back up photos and videos to it. I don't really use this feature a lot because I have Dropbox and Google Drive. Android messages in the web does not have this feature. But since it's a Google product, you have Google Photos and Google Drive for that. Speaking of photos, you can manage your phone gallery in MightyText Pro. I don't use this feature though. Since Android messages in the web is intimately tied to the actual text message app in your phone, you can mute people in the web and not get notifications from them, but still have texts come in. MightyText, Pro or otherwise, can't do that. You have the option to block numbers, but blocking is blocking. No texts will come in. Blocking is not muting. MightyText notifies you of every notification that shows up in your phone, but you have the option to fine-tune what to show. Their app has settings for that. But as a best practice, you should already aggressively choose who's allowed to notify you in your phone. Since I do that, I didn't really have to dictate to MightyText what apps' notification to hide from me on the web. One thing I love about MightyText is that it lets me know the charging status of my phone. And when it's not charging, it shows you the battery percentage. Android messages in the web currently does not have that yet. MightyText has a reminder feature, but I don't use that. It's handy though. You can also see all your phone contacts on MightyText. Android messages in the web does not have a tab for that. But of course, you can also just directly type contacts.google.com to your browser. But it would be nice if Android messages in the web had a tab or button for that. Note though, contacts.google.com only shows whatever contacts you synced with Google. MightyText grabs all the contacts in your phone, synced or not with Google. But sometimes it displays names weird if I have duplicate contacts in two different Google accounts. It's no big deal. MightyText also has a nifty ring my phone feature for when you don't know where your phone is. Which, yes, I know Google's Find My Device can ring your phone too, but then there's no bookmark to directly access that from Android messages in the web. You also have a little dial pad, and when you type in numbers here or press the keys, your phone makes the call. If you've seen my past phone reviews, I always use dual SIM phones. On my previous Flash Plus 2 phone, I didn't use Android messages because when I installed it, it didn't have the option to choose between sending a text using SIM 1 or SIM number 2. But on phones where Android messages is pre-installed at the factory by default, the option to toggle between sending a text using SIM number 1 or SIM number 2 is there in the text box. Yeah, I know about the option to choose ask every time in the global settings of the phone. But even with that option chosen, if I install Android messages on the phone that does not have it installed by default, I don't get to choose which SIM to send texts from. Also, this has nothing to do with Android messages on the web. I just thought to bring it up in case you have a dual SIM phone that does not have Android messages installed by default and you wanted to try out Android messages and then you can't switch between SIM number 1 and SIM number 2 and you're like shocked. Android messages on the web is also very new. Maybe this video won't be relevant anymore in the months to come as new features roll out. I just wanted to make this video now, since it's interesting to contrast these two text from the web services. As I'm a heavy MightyText user and I've been using it for years, and I often text from the web. Hope you found this video informative. Please thumb it up if you did, and consider subscribing so you can be updated when I upload again.